PolyMide CoPA is Polymakers' latest high-performance material that they released at the beginning of this year. In this video, we'll go into the printing quality and especially the material properties of this filament, but also try to get some insight into the change of properties why nylon parts get exposed to moisture. PolyMide CoPA is a polyamide 6 and 6,6 copolyamide. Most of you will know polyamide as nylon, which is actually a brand name, but I'll use this term as a synonym in this video. PolyMaker was kind enough to send me a roll of this filament a couple of weeks ago for review, so I had a bit of time to play around with it. The material comes nicely packed on 750g spools, which currently sell for around 70 euros, which makes it quite an expensive material. The rolls are vacuum sealed and you need to store them very dry, because nylon and especially PA6 and PA6,6 are very hygroscopic, meaning that they will absorb moisture out of the air and become unprintable in no time. So even though it might be feasible to use a normal spool holder for short prints, a dry box, just like I built on my own, or as PolyMaker is now selling, is a must in my opinion. PolyMide is advertised as an easy to print material that doesn't require a heated chamber, so I also printed all of my parts on my open Prusa i3 Mark IIs. An extrusion factor of simply 1.0 worked out perfectly for me and I had no problems at all with the parts sticking to the 70 degrees glue stick covered bed. I wasn't able to smell any unpleasant odor during printing. I tried nozzle temperatures between 240 degrees Celsius and 280 degrees Celsius and wasn't able to spot any major performance or quality differences, so I settled with 255 degrees for the rest of my tests. You can use a part cooling fan with this material, but in my tests I wasn't able to spot any major differences between 0 and 50%, so I just let it turned off. Overhang performance was okay, but you were already able to spot problems at 65 degrees. PolyMide showed some stringiness in the tests, but not as bad as some other nylons I've already worked with. Bridges were, well, how shall I put it, quite horrible. You might be able to tweak the settings, but out of the box they didn't print very well for me. I tried different fan settings, but that didn't change the results a lot. The obligatory 3D Banshee also reflects these results a little. Steep overhangs didn't print that well, and also the front window doesn't look the best, but there was hardly any stringing. I printed another Banshee in my makeshift heated chamber, which improved the overhang performance quite a bit, but otherwise didn't change a lot. Since this isn't a material which might normally be used for aesthetically pleasing prints, let's take a look at the mechanical performance. Before I go into details, let's talk about polyamide and moisture. As I already said before, this material will absorb water, and this will not only change the printing performance, but also mechanical properties. This is why, if you take a look at the material datasheet, you will see two sets of properties, one for the dry and one for the wet state. The material will be dried in its initial state, that it can be extruded to a filament, and that you can use it for printing. But after that, if you are not living in a dry desert, the material will slowly absorb moisture and this water will act as a plasticizer in the material, making it less rigid, but on the other side more tough. For injection molded parts, this is also an issue why they sometimes condition the parts after production to get the moisture in the part to a level near the value it will naturally go over time in normal air. This can be done using different methods. I boiled my specimens for 45 minutes, which might have been a little bit overkill, but well, we'll see that later. Alright, so now to the dry performance. With almost 70 megapascals of tensile strength, it's one of the strongest materials I've tested so far, and I couldn't get it to break in the test machine because it just yielded at some point. Layer adhesion with 39 megapascals is quite respectable, but only like 60% of the normal performance. Testing the pure filament even showed a better performance and the strands didn't fail below 80 megapascals. With around 2000 megapascals tensile modulus, it's quite a stiff material in its dry state. The strength of the hook that was printed lying on the bed was impressive and it was able to withstand 80 kilograms of load before it failed catastrophically. The standing hook was only able to bear 35 kilograms of load until it failed, which is less than half of the standard performance. Impact strength of the dried specimens was already impressive, but again, the standing specimens showed significantly less toughness, which is totally normal. The fracture surfaces looked great, and you were hardly able to notice that these were 3D prints. Temperature performance was very interesting. In the front, we see the dry specimen. In the back, we see the part that has been boiled for 45 minutes. The dry specimen starts to slightly soften at around 80 degrees Celsius, but is able to hold its shape up to 180 degrees Celsius when it then totally fails. The wet part on the other side doesn't seem to care up to almost 200 degrees Celsius when it started to soften noticeably and threw bubbles on the surface. I'm not 100% sure where this is coming from. Maybe the crystallinity increased in the water bath, or it might be cooling itself with the stored moisture. Maybe someone can help me out there? So as I have already said, your nylon parts will absorb moisture in ambient air and therefore change their properties over time. I wanted to speed up the process by boiling the parts where the parts absorb some water and also reduce their internal stresses, which result from the printing process. 45 minutes was probably a bit too long, and I ended up with moisture contents of around 4% in my samples, which gives them almost a rubber-like feel, making them almost instructable. This isn't extreme, and normal prints probably won't be absorbing that much. The piece of filament that I conditioned overnight in a bag with a wet cloth didn't fail anymore and only necked, ending up with only half the strength and around 30% less stiffness. The tensile specimens showed around the same reduction in strength, but with way more yielding, and something that I've never seen so far was that one of the layer adhesion samples yielded and started necking, which is very impressive. The hooks suffered a bit from the boiling procedure, showing some stress cracks already before the testing. This is probably due to the fact that the material absorbed moisture quite fast, which also changes dimensions a little bit. Strength was lower, but the hook now didn't break, but it flexed under the load and finally slipped from the holder. Impact strength was impressive, and the samples outperformed everything I've tested so far. One of the standing and one of the lying specimens was so strong that the hammer wasn't able to break it. All the other ones still improved in performance quite a lot. So there you have it. This was a close look at Polymakers PolyMide CoPA. Print quality is unfortunately not the best, and I'd appreciate if Polymaker would work on that. But I have to say that this is not a material you usually use for aesthetic prints, but more for functional ones. So if you designed your parts for additive, you'll still get decent looking prints. The thing that impressed me was the ease of use. No enclosure needed, great bed adhesion, no major warping. This multi-material gear with nylon on the teeth and the bearing in the middle and PLA for the rest, printed on the first try on my cheap Tivo Tarantula, and this is something I wouldn't have expected. Moisture is an issue as with most other nylons, so just keep that in mind for your designs. So, all in all, not the cheapest material with not the greatest looking prints, but if you look for a functional material that is easy to use and performs mechanically and temperature-wise great, definitely take a look at it. You can find links to the material and the test methods I used down in the description. The detailed test report, together with printing profiles and all the test samples, are available for my Patreons. If you enjoyed the video and learned something, then hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more. If you have suggestions and comments about my methods, please leave them down below and let me know what other materials you would like to see me investigate in the future. Until then, thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen, and I'll see you next time.